which you intend to fund. If you, O Lord, would mark iniquities, Lord, who could stand? But with you is found forgiveness, O God of Israel. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. Called to feast at the Lord's table, we come clothed with joy to give thanks to our God.
With you, O Lord, is found forgiveness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You destroy the veil that veils all people. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You will wipe away the tears from every face. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
The Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to the people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. May your grace, O Lord, we pray, at all times go before us, and to follow after and make us always determined to carry out good works. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will provide for all peoples a feast of rich food and choice wines, juicy, rich food and pure, choice wines. On this mountain, he will destroy the veil that veils all peoples. The web that is woven over all nations, he will destroy death forever. The Lord God will wipe away the tears from every face. The reproach of his people he will remove from the whole earth, for the Lord has spoken. On that day it will be said, "Behold our God to whom we look to save us. This is the Lord for whom we looked. Let us rejoice and be glad that he has saved us. For the hand of the Lord will rest on this mountain." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I shall live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life.
I shall live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life.
The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. In verdant pastures he gives me repose. Beside restful waters he leads me. He refreshes my soul. He guides me in the right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil. For you are at my side with your rod and your staff that give me courage. You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come. I shall dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. to live with abundance. In every circumstance, in all things, I have learned the secret of being well-fed and going hungry, of living in abundance and of being in need. I can do all things in Him who strengthens me. Still, it was kind of you to share in my distress. My God will fully supply whatever you need in accord with His glorious riches in Christ Jesus. To our God and Father, glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading of the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus again replied, spoke to the chief priests and the elders of the people in parables, saying, "The kingdom of heaven may be likened to a king who gave a wedding feast for his son. He dispatched his servants to summon the invited guests to the feast, but they refused to come. A second time he sent other servants, saying, 'Tell those invited, behold, I prepared my banquet. My calves and fatted cattle are killed, and everything is ready. Come to the feast.' Some ignored the invitation and went away, one to his farm, another to his business. The rest laid hold of his servants, mistreated them, and killed them. The king was enraged and sent his troops, destroyed these murderers, and burned their city. Then he said to his servants, 'The feast is ready, but those who were invited were not worthy to come. Go out, therefore, into the main roads and invite the feast whomever you may find.' The servants went out into the streets and gathered all they found, fat and good alike, and the hall was filled with guests." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good evening, my brothers and sisters in Christ. It is good to be with you again, be here again with you today, as we celebrate this 28th Sunday in Ordinary Time. And just around the corner is the Solemnity of Christ the King, which will end our liturgical season of Ordinary Time. And then we will begin our transition into Advent, followed by our beautiful Christmas season. Throughout this year, we have been hearing from the Gospels of Matthew. And all through these last several months, we have had the opportunity to experience the teachings of Jesus through the parables. They have their rich symbolism, and they are layered with theological insights. And today is no different. Our first reading from the prophet Isaiah describes a celebration of some sort, a festive meal. But the details are not too clear. Perhaps it is a victory celebration over battle with a neighboring foe, but no one knows for sure. The celebration would probably have taken place at Mount Zion in Jerusalem. Even though the details are not clear, it is certain that this is a precursor to our gospel story today. It is a feast described with juicy, rich food and pure choice wines. Only the very best will be provided on the Lord's mountain for all his people. A great feast where he will destroy death forever. It may not describe a wedding feast as we might think, but it does describe the wedding feast of the Lamb. In our church, we come to worship our God, a wedding feast of God's grace. This is Isaiah's promise that God will come as the Savior of all nations, where everyone will be satisfied. In our second reading from St. Paul to the Philippians, Paul talks about knowing what it's like to have too much and too little food to eat. But his concern is not for earthly good, but food for eternal life. For Paul, that begins with living a life in and for Christ. In this reading, Paul states one of the most beautiful thoughts: "I can do all things in shows that Paul has total faith in Jesus. His trust in God is complete and absolute. Our gospel from Matthew is a parable we are all too familiar with. It is the story of the king and his invited guest. But I wonder if we could look at this parable a little differently. Let's look at it symbolically and even a little metaphorically. If we think of the king as God our Father, the Son is Jesus Christ, with his bride being the church, for Jesus is called the bridegroom of the church. The first set of servants could be the early prophets, calling the Jews to repentance and right living. Many prophets were mistreated, beaten, and some killed, just like the king's servants. The second set of servants might be the apostles that Jesus called. There, the Pharisees and the Sadducees ignored Jesus and his followers and refused to heed their invitation to the feast. Again, many of them were mistreated and even killed. The last set of servants are the priests and religious and all who are called to minister in the church, calling everyone through baptism and belief in the one true God. But if we refuse to wear the wedding garment of true faith, we will be cast into the darkness where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth. You and I are all called to holiness. Pope St. John Paul II called for a new evangelization. Not to continue to send missionaries into the world, but to be missionaries in our homes and in our parishes. As this pandemic continues and social discord persists, there will be many opportunities for us to help evangelize. So I say, accept God's invitation to the wedding feast of the Lamb.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us raise our prayers up to God, whom we trust to fully supply whatever we need.
For the church, that we may always welcome all who approach with sincere hearts and be a model of acceptance and hospitality to all who seek refuge, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who feel unaccepted or unworthy due to their circumstances, hardships, or identity, that they may always realize God's inclusive invitation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a growing respect in society for all human life, from conception to natural death, from the mangroves to the dingy alleys, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those affected by Hurricane Delta, and those still recovering from other hurricanes and fires, may they know the comfort of God's love and be blessed with the strength to endure, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For indigenous peoples around the globe, especially those who have suffered generations of rejection or mistreatment, that they may be treated with respect and dignity,
Generous God, you shower everyone with your great generosity, bad and good alike, rich and poor alike. Grant us the grace to do the same as you hear the prayers we make today and every day through your greatest gift of all, your Son and our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual dream.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice.
Accept, O Lord, the prayers of your faithful with the sacrificial offerings, that through these acts of devotedness we may pass over to the glory of heaven through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. Having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so, with all the angels, we praise you. As a joyful celebration, we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, and sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread. And giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and William, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, St. Stephen, St. Gregory, St. Roch, Blessed Francis Xavier Silos, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us give each other an appropriate sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world.
takes away the sins of the world. Blessed it is called the Supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Please stand and we shall pray. We entreat your majesty most humbly, O Lord, that as you feed us with the nourishment which comes from the most holy body and blood of your Son,
so he may make us sharers of his divine nature, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Our catechism question of the day is, why must one become a disciple of Christ? A, in order to know the secrets of the kingdom of heaven. B, in order to receive the sacrament of the Eucharist. C, in order to be baptized. D, in order to bear his cross. All of you who think it's A, in order to know the secrets of the kingdom of heaven, raise your hand. All of you who think it's B, in order to receive the sacrament of the Eucharist. All of you who think it is C, in order to be baptized. All of you who think it is D, in order to bear his cross. Looks like the majority of you like E. Father, be quiet. The answer is A, in order to know the secrets of the kingdom of heaven. Paragraph 546. Jesus' invitation to enter his kingdom comes in the form of parables, a characteristic feature of his teaching. Through his parables, he invites people to the feast of the kingdom, but he also asks for radical choice. To gain the kingdom, one must give everything. Words are not enough. Deeds are required. The parables are like mirrors for man. Will he be hard soil or good earth for the word? What use has he made of the talents he has received? Jesus and the presence of the kingdom in this world are secretly at the heart of the parables. One must enter the kingdom, that is, become a disciple of Christ, in order to know the secrets of the kingdom of heaven. For those who stay outside, everything remains enigmatic. Next week's question is, when is a citizen obliged in conscience not to follow the directives of civil authority? Oh my. That's in the catechism. Number of announcements. Don't forget, this coming week I will be attending our annual canon law conference at my dining room table. Looking at a screen from 9 in the morning until way in the evening. So I will not be having masses during the week until Friday this week. So I've got some good conferences, looking forward to it. I'm going to miss the interaction we normally able to have, but I will be sequestered during that time. Be careful. Some people have told me that people are getting these things in the mail saying and indicating that they're not able to vote, because they don't have this or they don't have that. It's hooey. It's hooey. Call the county clerk's office where you live to double check. Please pass that on. Network with people. Tell me you've been hearing these stories. See if anyone has heard it. Ask them to talk to people. Make sure people realize there's a scam going on out there. Try to get not to get people to vote. Please talk about it a lot and ask people to talk about it, okay? Because we're going to make sure that the truth is out, that everybody can vote. Also, our early in-person voting here in the county begins on Tuesday this week, okay? You received in the mail, and we've been sending you information and talking about it in the bulletin about the Disciples Response Fund. Next week will be our big push for that. We're asking you to consider supporting this wonderful outreach in the diocese. You have been an awesome parish in doing this throughout the year since I've been here, and I'd like to encourage you to do so. And so if you could fill that out, mail it in. If not, bring it in the next weekend, and we'll then mail it in for you. We do encourage you to definitely be a part of that. Next Sunday is also a second collection for World Mission Sunday. That helps all the poor dioceses throughout the world. So your support of that will be appreciated as well. Next
Saturday night at this Mass, we're going to have a visitor, Bishop Medley. He is, like everybody else, going quarantine crazy. So he's going to be here next Saturday. And I said, oh, good, you get to read your disciples' response letter. He said, no, you read it, because I'm too embarrassed. So anyway, he'll be here. He'll have a brief message. He just wants to get out and be with the community. Nothing big, nothing fancy, no meals, nothing like that. He's just coming in to have Mass with us. So I just want you to know that and to look forward to it, okay? And I hope he'll show up and that somebody is here, okay? That would be very helpful. Also, we're going to start putting up in the Narthex some bulletins. And if you're going to start taking them and you don't need them mailed, please let Dean know. So we're having to spend a lot of money putting out bulletins into the mail. If you would like to get on a regular basis and you're not getting a bulletin, please let Dean know. And if you hear a mess and you don't want to get on the internet, grab one on your way out. But remember, don't touch all of them because we don't need to share all your cooties. I had a great experience this afternoon. I went out to get the mail, and there's a lot of traffic on Canton Road today. There was a terrible truck fire on I-24, I don't know if you're aware of that, but it actually closed down all of the eastbound lanes, right? And then it closed the westbound lanes for a while as well. It's a real big traffic jam. Well, all of a sudden, they heard these diesel trucks shifting gears, and two of them pulled in across the place because I was getting mail. And they pulled in, this guy got out, and I said, I'm going to go check on him. Are you okay? He says, my GPS, how do I get to Nashville? The poor guy, and this other guy's following him, and they had no GPS, so I got them on their way. But anyway, what a mess. I can't imagine. So pray. Pray for everyone that's still caught up in that, and those who survived it, that their blood pressure didn't go too bad. Woody, I like your new see-through mask. That's lovely.
Trying
it
out,
accentuates Father. Your mouth in a bigger way. I don't know if you know that.
Thank you.
Ever since the mask has been on, I've had more fun looking at people going, that's interesting. It's how it forms to people in different ways, how people look. Another favorite one is when it's wrapped so tightly around a person, it almost looks like they have no facial features. But thank you for sharing that view with us today. We appreciate your being a fashionista.
Experimental.
Experimental, I'm sure it is. Well, let's say our prayer to Mary, asking her intercession during the pandemic. Oh, Mary, you always shine on our path as a sign of salvation and of hope. We entrust ourselves to you, health of the sick, who at the cross took part in Jesus' pain, keeping your faith firm. You, salvation of all people, know what we need, and we are sure you will provide, so that as in Cana of Galilee, we may return to joy and to feasting, after this time of trial. Help us, Mother of Divine Love, to conform to the will of the Father, and to do as we are told by Jesus, who has taken upon himself our sufferings and carried our sorrows, to lead us through the cross to the joy of the resurrection. Amen. Under your protection, we seek refuge, Holy Mother of God. Do not disdain the entreaties of we who are in trial, but deliver us from every danger, O glorious and blessed Virgin. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Blessing. May the God of all consolation order your days in his peace and grant you the gifts of his blessing.
Amen.
May he free you always from every distress, and confirm your hearts in his love.
Amen.
So that in this life's journey, you may be effective in good works, rich in the gifts of hope, faith, and charity, and may come happily to eternal life.
Amen.
And may the blessings of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you.